Hello everybody, and a very warm welcome to LMT YouTube channel.
The Duke made an appearance at the Stand for Heroes event, which went virtual for the first time. Stand Up for Heroes was started by a BC News correspondent, Bob Woodruff, 14 years ago, shortly after he suffered devastating head injuries in Iraq while covering the war, which left him in a coma for 40 days. The aim of the event is to raise awareness and funds for the Bob Woodruff Foundation, whose mission to help veterans and military families thrive is especially vital as veterans face increased challenges due to the COVID-19 pandemic.
Our next guest served in his nation's armed forces for 10 years, rising to the rank of captain. And after two tours in Afghanistan, he made a huge commitment to support wounded men and women as they adapted to civilian life post-injury. And when I say he's a true prince of a guy, I mean that literally. He is Prince Harry, Duke of Sussex.
Good evening. I'm really pleased to be part of tonight's gathering for a cause that is so close to my heart. Thank you, Bob, for your ongoing friendship and for your commitment to veterans and their families. My experience in the military made me who I am today. It also connected me with some of the strongest, funniest, and most memorable people I've ever met. Once we join this team, we are always part of this team. Once we have served, we are always serving, and proudly so. In war, you see things you hope no one else has to see. You prepare yourself as much as possible, but truth be told, nothing can really prepare you. So much was being sacrificed without recognition, and so many lives were forever changed. I wanted to honor the legacy of these men and women who have given up so much, from time with family, to birthdays missed, and even births missed. Some lost their limbs, and others lost their lives.
In memory of all of our fallen comrades who didn't make it, we are Invictus.
It is for that reason that I created the Invictus Games. To give injured servicemen and women a platform to excel and reaffirm their values of resilience, of community and strength, which are inherent in each and every one of us. Frankly, that experience changed my life forever and for the better. It changed how I viewed sacrifice and service. I was born into a life of duty, but it was during my decade in the Army that I committed to a life of service. Tonight, we honor and advocate for our veterans and their loved ones. For the whole world, this year has been and continues to be incredibly hard. But we've also seen incredible resilience and purpose. As far as I see it, service is what happens in the quiet and in the chaos. It's what happens when people aren't looking. And it's about how we take care of each other every single day. As we reflect on the past year, a universally tough year, the leadership and values that are represented in this community, in our community, are more important now than ever. Thank you to those who came before us. Thank you to everyone who upholds the service values in everything that they do. And thank you to our loved ones for the unwavering support.
We particularly loved when Harry said, "I was born into a life of duty, but it was during my decade in the Army that I committed to a life of service." We also loved this part. "My experience in the military made me who I am today, and it also connected me with some of the strongest, funniest, and most memorable people I've ever met," the Duke of Sussex said during the event. "I wanted to honor the legacy of these men and women who have given up so much, from time with family to birthdays missed, and even births missed. Some lost their limbs and others lost their lives. It's for that reason that I created the Invictus Games, to give injured servicemen and women a platform to excel and reaffirm their values of resilience, of community and strength, which are inherent in each and every one of us. The people's prince, a military man through and through.
Of community and strength, which are inherent in each and every one of us. Frankly, that experience changed my life forever and for the better. It changed how I viewed sacrifice and service. I was born into a life of duty, but it was during my decade in the Army that I committed to a life of service. Tonight, we honor and advocate for our veterans and their loved ones. For the whole world, this year has been and continues to be incredibly hard.
Another analysis.
The reason why Meghan Markle wears the color blue so often, with blue being among the spectrum of recognized royal colors, It's no surprise that it's one of the Duchess of Sussex's favorite colors to wear. Meghan Markle has been photographed a number of times wearing a particular shade of blue that, while perceived as turquoise, is in fact more unique. In fact, during her pregnancy with baby Archie, Meghan wore blue so much, fans thought she was using the color to hint at the sex of her first child with husband Prince Harry. But the Duchess's preferred shade isn't your typical blue. According to color expert Gabriella Winters, Meghan wears a distinctive shade of blue that's known for its history and infrared healing abilities. In May 2020, Winters said, "Coincidentally, the type of blue that Duchess Meghan has been sporting frequently is called Egyptian blue. And this shade receives its name from the first ever artificial pigment invented 5,000 years ago. Leave it up to this fashion-forward royal to introduce us to a color that does more than just look good when worn." Meghan Markle's preferred shade of blue was once a secret beauty weapon. According to Gabriella Winters, Egyptian blue is rumored to have the ability to keep skin looking smooth and rejuvenated, a possible reason why Meghan Markle wears it so much. Winters said, "Infrared has the ability to penetrate the deepest layers of the skin and stimulate cells to produce collagen. Could this be the secret to Meghan's flawless skin? Somehow I doubt that modern pigments would be smart enough to emit infrared light. But Egyptian blue could have certainly been a secret beauty weapon of princesses of the ancient past." The Duchess was spotted in shades of Egyptian blue while on her trip to Africa alongside husband Prince Harry, while out and about in Australia, and during one of her final appearances in the United Kingdom, before she and her family relocated to the United States. But when taking a deeper look into the significance of the color blue, it makes sense why Meghan might use the color to harness her zen. Winters explained, "Psychologically speaking, blue is the most popular color in the entire world because of its non-threatening placid nature. It is the color of peace and quiet, and it signifies freedom. In the world of business, blue is the mark of formality, and it symbolizes one's loyalty and devotion to their work."
We just want to annoy you for 3 seconds. That is, please click the subscribe button to get more attractive videos from us. Your support is also the motivation for our team to produce better videos with more quality content. And now we do not let you wait any longer. Let's start the story.
Prince Harry has been spotted volunteering for a nonprofit organization which provides COVID-19 support for army veterans and their families. The Duke of Sussex was low-key in a pair of jeans, trainers, and a face mask as he packaged up fresh food parcels for the Walker Family Events Foundation in Compton last week. After the visit, the nonprofit publicly thanked the royal on their Instagram page. Walker Family Events co-founder Tia praised the prince, "Today I had the honor of meeting and working alongside Prince Harry, Duke of Sussex. He joined us in volunteering at Compton VFW for the Operation Nourish program, packing and distributing food to our Compton neighbors. What's more," the fan described Harry, who stepped down as a senior member of the royal family in March, "as very humble and kind." The organization Compton Veterans has partnered with the Inner City Child Development and Youth Foundation to deliver weekly food parcels for those struggling in the local community. The weekly event relies on volunteers to set up the stalls and hand out the fresh food parcels. Walker Family Events says the coronavirus crisis has had a huge effect on their work, and that volunteers like Prince Harry are needed now more than ever.
Check out one of our newest videos right here, plus even more LMT videos about your favorite stuff. For coming soon, subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one. Stop.